All right, TIFF is coming, the Toronto International Film Festival, which will feature all these luminaries and now a movie with Jim Gaffigan. We'll get to that in a little bit. We're glad you're here. Good morning to you.
It's an honor to be here.
And this is what pleases me to no end. The bagels were to your liking.
The bagels were great.
I feel we don't treat our guests well enough, that we need to have more stuff.
Well, I think the most important element is that it was free.
Right.
Yeah, that helps.
But it was very good.
But you're a New Yorker saying that a California bagel lived up to your
standards. Was surprising. But you know, again, it just comes down to the food being free.
So what about this whole inverse relationship between your ability to afford stuff and the amount of free stuff you get? So when you have no money, there's no free stuff.
Right.
And now that things are going well, there's endless free stuff.
Oh no, it's insane. It's really, but the world is unfair.
Yeah.
And I tell you, I take all the money I make and I donate it. Every single penny.
That's very
so
generous.
So
no,
generous.
It's very, I feel very fortunate. I'm a lucky bastard.
What's your favorite freebie stuff? Like, is there a drawer in your house somewhere that has, you know, 80 pairs of sunglasses and all that?
I'm not allowed to, you know, like the swag bag.
Right.
I'm not allowed to bring that stuff home.
Oh.
Because it's, I don't need any of this.
Sure.
Stuff. Like, there's makeup. They give, I don't need makeup. You know what I mean? I'm too good looking anyway.
Uh-huh.
Right.
No, but they give men makeup in these bags, and I don't use it because I don't. You know, but I don't care what I look like.
Doesn't the missus like all that stuff or doesn't care?
She likes some of it, but I think a lot of it's, you know, it's like the equivalent of a whoopee cushion. Now, right? You're like, oh, this is amazing if I ever open an umbrella store.
Yeah. It is kind of a whoopee cushion. When you do the Noble Ape tour happening now, your chance to see Jim locally, talking about that in a second. Do you get a feel for the places you go, or is it just pop, 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 pop?
Well, it's different in every city. I mean, I love the fact that, you know, I'll be in downtown L.A., you know, at the Ace Theater is a different vibe. It's very intimate. It's a great theater. But, you know, yeah, I mean, I don't know. L.A. is unique unto itself. You know, it's like everyone in the audience has some connection to the entertainment industry. So it's different from, say, you know, if you're in Cedar Rapids, mm-hmm. where they're like, it's exciting. You know, in L.A., people are like, oh, it's just a show.
Right. Yeah. All right. So does that make it harder to kind of cut through, or?
I think so. But then again, I also think that the communication is, there's a certain level of intimacy with people that in the entertainment industry. You're like, you get some of what I'm saying.
Well, speaking of which, we'll show you a little clip from one of Jim's specials, all these Netflix specials. Watch this.
I do like being married to a strong, decisive woman. But you know what? I'm in charge of the remote control. That's where I draw the line, all right? I'm in charge of the remote because I'm the man, all right? I mean, she picks all the shows we watch, but I get to hold the remote. Because that's the kind of puppet dictator that I am. Being in charge of the remote control is a no-win situation anyway. The person you're watching with is never satisfied. They're like, turn it up, I can't hear it. Then you turn it up and the commercial comes on. Turn it down, what's wrong with your hearing? I'm always in trouble when we watch television.
Does your wife think you're funny?
I think so. Well, I work together with my wife. We write together.
Right.
So, yeah, I would say, yeah. I mean, not as much as she did 15 years ago.
Everything wears off.
Yeah, she thinks I'm funny, I suppose. You know, it's her patience is worn thin.
But do you ever get where you're, not? I don't want to say a fight, but it's a serious moment, and then you're over there joking around, and then that gets...
There is some of that.
Yeah.
There is some of that. But again, some of the stuff that used to alleviate the tension, it doesn't work anymore. We have five kids.
Oh,
and,
boy.
Oh, and what's the age range of the five kids?
I have no idea.
Okay.
Right.
No, 13, 11, 8, 6, and 4.
So you're not busy at all.
Oh, my goodness.
It's very busy.
And didn't you tour with them for a while?
I do. I tour often with my kids.
Right.
I don't have them with me
right.
now. And
so
I frankly don't miss them at all. But no, but yeah, we tour and we travel. We're less of a family. We're more of a mob.
Uh-huh.
Like we have walked into restaurants. We walked into a restaurant in Boston, and I saw a waitress look at my family quit her job.
She threw in her apron.
It's daunting. Yeah.
Yes, it's just like they're just young, crazy kids.
Right,
they're constantly making noise.
Right. Yeah. I say, I have four, and I say at my house, shh, all the time.
Yeah, no, it's just... When they're quiet, it's almost like then you get nervous.
Because what are they doing?
You're like, it's like before like a tornado or something.
Right.
It's too quiet if there's not a noise constantly being made.
This film, Chappaquiddick, and the minute you say the title, we know what it's about. Toronto International Film Festival. First dramatic work for you ever?
Well, it was fun playing Mary Jo Kopechne.
It was
an amazing experience. I mean, we all know the story, and it's a fascinating look at this story that, you know, really kind of changed the course of America. And it was a great opportunity to kind of wrap myself in a different kind of role. I played a lawyer, Paul Markham, who was part of the cover-up, and, you know, it was fun to play a smart guy.
And did you think, not that you didn't have the chops to do it, but since it's seemingly, for those of us, it's a totally different arena for you.
Yeah, but, you know, I think that there's comedians that love acting, and then there's comedians that don't care about acting. Mm-hmm. And the comedians that love acting, it's not a huge leap. You know, comedians are very spoiled. We go on stage and we can say whatever we want. And acting is really, it's important about doing whatever's best for the scene or the movie. And I like being part of a piece of a cog in a movie. It's just the process of getting acting jobs that's brutal. It's, you know, auditioning is like stripping, but you don't get a dollar.
It's true. Hey, but now, often when you audition, you walk in a room and there's 10 guys who look just like you.
Yeah, well, I often walk in a room and people look at me like, no. I just spent 5 hours preparing.
Yeah. Many things. Cinco, one of Jim's specials, is on Netflix. You can download it on iTunes. Chances to see Jim live on the Noble Ape Tour, Ace Theater, which is a great, great venue. That's a lovely.
That's lovely.
I look nothing like that.
That looks really
nice.
Who's
that guy?
I look nothing like that.
A three-night stay, September 7th, 8th, and 9th. Tonight, then.
Tonight, yes.
JimGaffigan.com for ticket information there. Really appreciate
you
coming.
Thanks so much, you guys. Of course.
Great to see you.
Once people get to your level, they often don't come back.
No, I love coming back.
All right, great. Thanks.